Sometimes we represent that as a one variable or two variable. Okay. Most of the time it will be only one variable, and then that independent variable will be times most of the time. Okay. We pretty much have this kind of thing. Okay. One dimension signal. Okay. The two dimension signal that you used to. Okay. It's a commonly two dimension signal. It will be the digital or the picture. Okay, or the digital picture or the image. Okay, that will be two dimension signal. Okay, and normally the signal we will carry some information. Okay, you can think about that the signal is really a carrier that carry information, passing the information around. Okay, so that's the reason why we have to process the signal in order to get the information out of the signal. Okay. And the way that we represent the signal can be either one of these equations. Okay, so it will be, for example, like the first one, signal S is equal to AT. T it will be independent variable. Okay, and that will be, this is a linear equation, this is a second order. Okay, and then that will be the sine wave that you're talking about. Okay, and that one will be the two dimension, because now you have two variable, two independent variable x and y. Okay, according to that, so the whole thing that we call the representation of the signal, so we kind of represent the signal in the mathematic point of view. Okay. And okay, in the signal theory, we separate them into three classes. The first one will be the thing that we call the modeling. The modeling is something that you try to determine the model of the signal. Okay, and then the second one, pretty much the one that this one is the analysis. Okay, so it will be the process that we try to extract or to retrieve the information out of the signal. Okay, we call this one the signal processing sometime. Okay, and the design will be something that you try to synthesis. For example, if we try to, now we have a system, okay, you can see that we try to do the system that try to analyze the voice of the human voice. Okay, try to analyze which word that they say, or something like that. Okay, before that, okay, we have to model how the word come out, how the human produce the voice out of the mouth. Okay, so in that case, we have to do modeling, and before we can get the modeling, sometimes you have to analyze it. Okay, you use it as an example, analyze what is it look like when you said each word. For example, when you said ka. Okay, what is the signal look like? Okay, something like that. And then after that, at the final part, okay, sometimes you want to design a system that can be able to synthesis any voice. Okay, when I said any voice, it means that not just only the human's voice. Sometimes you want to add some emotion in the voice. You will say something, the same sentence, but if you said it when you are angry, okay, what is the voice should come out? Okay, it shouldn't say it exactly the same, so it will be like a robot saying something. Okay, so but main our focus will be on that part most of the time. Okay, those two, okay, will be the first one and the second on the last one will be something in the signal processing, almost at the end. Okay, modeling and the design. Okay. If we study the DSP, we have to do design some system, but the system that we will design, it will be the filter design, okay, for the DSP. Okay, so that's the example of the voice signal. Okay, for some of you who really play with hi. So how many times are you going to come in this class? This semester, how many times? Last semester you come into the class only two times. Every day we have a class only on Tuesday. Okay? If you're coming in every day, you will see somebody else. Okay, so this is a voice signal. Okay, if you're playing with the Wi-Fi, okay, you will see this more often. Okay, this will be the independent variable, it's time, and then that we call the amplitude. Okay, and this is a speech signal, or sometimes we voice signal. Okay, that this signal is represents the air pressure that's coming out from your throat. Okay, from your throat it's coming out, it's like an air pressure chain, so it turned out to be this kind of signal. Okay, actually we really convert from that, okay, from the air pressure, okay, into the electrical signal, and this is represent the air pressure in a way. Okay, it has been changed from air pressure from mechanical, okay, to the electrical signal. Okay, and then what is the information it carry? It carry the voice, it carry the word information, okay, the sentence information. Okay, and then this one will be the two-dimension signal. Okay, this is the picture or the image. Okay, this is the picture that computer see. Okay, the picture that you see will be the one on the right side. Okay, exactly the same. This is two dimension. Each piece of this, okay, on that one will be one dimension, and then it's stacked all together. Okay, so you will get, this will be, for example, you can think about this is the X dimension and this Y dimension. Okay, and then the amplitude will be the amplitude of intensity. Okay, light intensity. So actually your picture, okay, will be a signal that represent the light intensity. Okay, the information it carry, it will carry something that it's a perception of your eye. Okay, well, it depends on your perception. What is this one? A football? Huh? You say something? Blood. Why you say it's blood? You don't know. Okay. Yeah, so now you have to have some knowledge in order to be able to, okay, extract some information out of that. Okay, actually it's a red blood cell, yes. Okay, it's a red cell, it's a red blood cell, or metal dang, or whatever. Okay, that's the picture. Okay, so I think this is a picture. Those two are exactly the same. Okay, top view. You view it from the top, you will see this picture. Okay, when you look at this one from the top view, you see this one. Okay, think about the white is zero and the black is a higher number. Okay. Okay, but the something that we will learn, I think, is will be the signal that we have. Okay, normally for the nature or the signal that come up. Okay, naturally, it will be something that we call the continuous signal. The continuous signal will be a signal that have the value or the present. It's present at all time, okay, and it can have an infinite value. Okay, it can have any value. Okay, for example, like this one, okay, we call this is a continuous signal, or sometimes we call the analog signal. Okay, it's present at all time. Okay, and then it can have any value. Okay, for example, even though that you can have 9.001, 9.25 or something like that. Okay, so we can say that the analog signal, it will be continuous in time and continuous in value or amplitude. Okay, now but this type of a signal the computer cannot handle. Okay, because